This is probably the most mixed I've been on the screen movie thus far. It's probably my least favorite. Scream 4 is, get this, the fourth Scream movie. Wow, go figure. As I said in the intro to this video, I'm indifferent on this movie. I don't think it's great, but I don't think it's bad either. I think it's just okay. There's some days where I do prefer Scream 3 over this, but if I'm gonna be realistic with myself, Scream 3 is the lesser of the two. But anyway, that's enough fooling around. Let's get into this movie. So what does this follow? Well, this is about 10 years after Scream 4, no, Scream 3, I meant. It follows that movie. Sydney is coming back to Woodsboro because there's murders and stuff. This follows her niece, nephew, cousin, something, I don't know. Follows her and her group of friends who are getting attacked by Ghostface. It's another murder mystery. And, well, this movie... It's good in certain aspects. There's others that I just think is just so bad. Let's get into that. So, first and foremost, we have the opening kill in this movie. I think this opening kill is not very good. Because it's a bunch of different opening kills. It's a bunch of fake-outs. Now, this was Wes Craven's last Scream movie before he unfortunately passed. So, he wanted to go off a bang, I presume, with the Scream franchise because he didn't know if he would get to do more after this. It's something. It's okay, but it's just not really what I want from a Scream opening. I would rather be focused on one character, either trying to stop a murder, or getting murdered, or being called by Ghostface, or whatever. This opening is just, oh, it's a movie instead of a movie instead of a movie, and it was just like, kind of felt a little pretentious. I do like seeing, of course, Dewey, Gale, Sydney come back in this movie. It's definitely great to have them here, and it makes it a whole lot more tolerable because the new characters, not much of a fan of. Sydney's great in this. Dewey, who's finally sheriff and he's married to Gale and they're living together, and it's just so cathartic. Even though in the next movie, he dies. I am really sad about that. When I went back to this movie, I was just like, oh god, I have to watch him die in the next one. dang it. But anyway, with this movie, main character is Jill. She's aight. She's fine. She's basically being pitched as your new Sydney, which I'm gonna get to the ending of this movie later. And she does a fine enough job of what she's supposed to be there for, which is to be the new Sydney, and it's okay. It's just not really nothing like too special, if that makes any sense. It's just like, the actress is great. She's a really good actress, and she was great in, I think it was Nerve, I believe. Yeah, that movie, I really enjoyed that movie. She was good in that. Here, she's just kinda, she's aight, she's fine, even at the end, she's still just like, not great. The other main cast characters is basically the original movie, but done again. But here, they do add a little bit of element where they have this class that's a bunch of film nerds, which I guess you can say was done in Scream 2 also. But this is a little different because they're having a stab-a-thon. They watch all the stab movies, and it's a really fun sequence. Ghostface, this movie, he's fine. He gets a really good kill in the bedroom, which I don't want to spoil it, but it's really, really good. And because it's just, well, you know, I'm going to spoil it, because might as well. It's like he calls Kirby, who's his other character, so I'm going to get to a second, and Jill, making him think he's in their house. He's actually in their friend's house next door, kills her. And it's a brutal kill. It reminds me of the first movie, with the opening with Drew Barrymore. Kirby in this movie, she's very good, I think. She is actually coming back in Scream 6, which I'm excited about. Even though this movie kind of makes you feel like she's dead, because she kind of gets killed. I love Kirby in this movie. She was kind of like her Randy in a way, but like, I don't know, she had a little more swagger to hers. I liked her a lot, and I cannot wait to see her in Scream 6 Screams with 2 exclamation points. I don't know what that movie's gonna be called. The going back to Woodsboro in this movie is cool, because the second one, you're in college, the third one, you're in Hollywood, this one, we're back at Woodsboro. It's good. I think the fifth movie did that a lot better. Made it feel a lot more grand, being back there. But this movie doesn't find enough trouble for it. There's not much to talk about in this movie, until you get to a certain scene. There's a good scene in the barn, by the way, that I love. That's not to stab upon. It's really good with Gale. Such a good scene. Anyway. So, this is a big plot point in this movie. You know how Scream is with the murders and the killers and all this stuff? Well, let's get into that. Spoilers, you've been warned. The main killer of this movie is Macaulay Culkin's brother, who I forgot to mention. And, Jill, which is kind of cool. I think that's a good twist in theory. I just didn't get connected to the Jill character, where I'm just like, oh, she cannot be the killer. I mean, she can never be. She's supposed to be in New City. But not gonna lie, I expected her from moment one when she came on screen. She was my number one suspect, because she just had a vibe about her throughout the whole movie. And I don't know, it just didn't really work. And her plan towards like, oh, I'm gonna be in a New City, you know, because I had to watch you grow up and be like all in the spotlight, and I wasn't in it. It's a tried and tribute plot. But it works fine enough, and I do like how the ending where she thinks Sydney's dead, so she's actually gonna go. She does go through with her plan, which more ghost faces would do. More would survive past the third act twist, which I think would be. I want six to do. I actually kind of want to make a video about six. I have a lot of theories. Anyway, so yeah, she hurts herself, makes herself look like she got attacked by Ghostface, and it's a really good scene. I really like it a lot. It's different for the franchise. It's a different kind of killer, which I think this is what this needed. This movie came out in 2011, after all. This was 10 years after third. They needed to do something different, and this was different. Yeah, that was good. I don't know. I just don't really like. It's fine. It's one of my least favorite killers of the franchises, because I'm just. She's just kind of plain. I don't know. Even though she has a lot of letters, she's just kind of plain. Anywho, it's my thoughts about the whole big plot in the end, and that she gets killed by, I think, Sydney, where she goes, yeah, you can't beat the original. I thought that was kind of cool. But anyway, also the lighting in this movie is really bad. It looks way too bright. But anyway, I thought this movie was fine. It's not a great movie by any means, but it's not a bad one either. It doesn't go to like the craziness of Scream 2 and 3, but it's not like as great as the first, or it's not like as kind of middle, pretty good as the fifth. It's probably my least favorite in the franchise, honestly. I'd probably give it like a. So yeah, that was my thoughts on Scream 4. So this was a very anticlimactic review to start off, and I didn't praise, I didn't hate, I just was like, it's fine. Which is kind of crazy. My least favorite Scream movie is one I think is just okay. Go figure. Anyway, so tell me in the comments below, you guys thought of Scream 4. Or just now kicking off Cinema Ween 3. Can't believe I've done this for 3 years now. And we're going to be covering, actually, Halloween 2 next time. Tomorrow, I guess. And going into Halloween Ends. I'm going to talk about all the Halloween movies, because, I mean, now is a good time to talk about them. Better than going through them, like, year by year, just get them all the way while the new one's coming out. There will probably be another one. Yeah, I will see you guys next time. Thank you.